Here's a stack of my Uncle Bert's newspapers. Whenever he gets a newspaper, he just puts it down in a pile. Anything look, odd to you? This makes sense from what we said before with when we talked about relative age dating, that the older newspapers are at the bottom. The oldest newspaper, April 27th, is the bottom newspaper. The youngest newspaper, May 26th, is at the top. But you should have noticed that there is a little bit of a gap here. We've got April 27th down here at the bottom. There's the April 28th paper right there, the April 29th paper, the April 30th paper, the May 1st paper, the May 2nd paper, the May 3rd paper, the Star Wars paper, the May 5th paper. And then we get a jump, the May 20th paper. Well, wait a second. I think we've got something missing. Where are all the May 6th, 7th, 8th, 9th, 10th, 11th, 12th, 13th, 14th, 15th, 16th, 17th, 18th, 19th papers? What could have possibly happened to those papers? Well, there's a couple different options. Maybe those papers were never delivered on those days. Maybe my Uncle Bert forgot to pay his bill and they never delivered them. Or maybe he went on vacation, he had his neighbor collect those papers. Maybe those papers were delivered and they were in the stack. Uncle Bert read them and put them back onto the stack, but then he needed some newspapers for something. Maybe he just got a puppy. Maybe he needed the newspapers to start a campfire. So he grabbed that stack from May 6th to May 19th and he took those papers away. So then the next day, when he got the May 20th paper, when he put it down, he just put it down on top of the May 5th paper. Those papers from May 6th to May 19th were there, but then they were just taken away and they were used. Well, we're going to use this same idea to talk about how this can happen to some rocks as well. If you take a look at the next page of your notes, it talks about relative age dating. We're still under this idea of not knowing exactly how old a rock is, but trying to figure out how old one rock layer is or an event that happens compared to some others. And we're going to focus on this idea of unconformities. If you conform, that means you follow the normal rules. We're going to take a look at some situations that don't necessarily fit, kind of like these newspapers. Something didn't fit. Something was missing. Something was out of order. These unconformities. I'd like to lead you through an understanding of the diagram here. Notice that we have on the left-hand side, I've got rock layers A, B, C, D, and E, and you know that rock layer A is the oldest rock layer. To show that, I said that that rock layer is 40 million years ago is when that rock layer was deposited. So 40 million years ago, and rock layer E, 36 million years ago. That's younger. It's more recent. Up above, I've got the ocean. So this is all ocean water up here. Those rock layers have been deposited in the ocean over a number of millions of years. Because of tectonic forces, this area may be lifted up. Notice that the entire area, A, B, C, and D, has been uplifted. That whole land has been moved up. The oceans have been pushed away. We can see that there are some trees on the land now. So because of uplift, this land gets lifted above the oceans. Now that it's above the ocean, above sea level, we have some weathering and erosion are now going to start eating away at the rock. And you'll notice that some of those rock layers are missing. I still have rock layers. I still have rock layer A. I still have rock layer B. And I still have a piece of rock layer C, although it looks like some of rock layer C has been weathered and eroded away. Rock layers D and E, which were there, have now been destroyed by weathering and erosion. So between the process of uplift and weathering and erosion, we have some rock that used to be there that has now been destroyed. This land, again, because of tectonic processes, might subside and the ocean might come back once again. So now that I've got this ocean, remember, this is all ocean water here. Millions of years later, I'm going to get some more deposition in the ocean. And this time I've got deposition of layers F, G, and H. But notice the dates of F, G, and H. F was deposited 34 million years ago, G, 33, H, 32 million years ago. And here, just like we saw with our newspapers, we've got a 40 million year old, 39 million year old, 38, and we've got some rock that's missing. 34, 33, and 32. Well, wait, what about the 37s, the 36s, the 30, 35s? Where did that time go? Well, it appears that right here between rock layers C Notice the next rock layer is not D and E. Those have been destroyed away. In between C and F, we have a boundary that represents some missing rock. It's a rock that either was there and was destroyed or was never deposited during that time. We call that an unconformity. An unconformity is wherever previous rock has been destroyed by weathering and erosion. We say there's a buried erosional surface there. There's a gap in time where there's an unconformity. Just like there was a gap in time with the newspapers, here we have a gap in time in our rock layers. Oftentimes, this is very obvious. As you can see here in this picture, we've got one rock layer, a number of rock layers that have been folded on the bottom, but then we've got a rock layer on the top that is not. So right here, we have an unconformity. Let's take a look at how an unconformity forms. So here's the ocean. We have deposition of layers in the ocean. We know that layer number one is going to be the oldest layer since it was deposited first. We have five different layers. The ocean is gone due to some uplift. Weathering and erosion destroys some of those layers. Notice there's only a little bit of layer five left. After some subsidence, we have more deposition in the ocean, and we've got an unconformity between some layers. Here in this diagram, we could see that there's an igneous intrusion, but notice how that igneous intrusion just stops. Well, wait a second, what's going on right along here? That igneous intrusion probably continued on and intruded into some other rocks, but that those other rocks are now gone. That igneous intrusion, which used to be here, has now been weathered and eroded away. And then this new rock layer was deposited on top of that. So right here at this boundary, we have an unconformity. Right here at this boundary, we have an unconformity. In this diagram that you may or may not see on a quiz or test, we have a lot of different events going on. Our first event would be these layers of G, F, E, and D get deposited. Those are the only layers, the only things that are folded, so we know our next event would be folding. After they're folded, they're intruded by igneous intrusion A. All of those layers, as well as igneous intrusion A, are cut by fault XY. And some people would then say, oh, the next thing would be deposition of C and B. But before we have deposition of C and B, there's an unconformity. That unconformity, which happens right in this area here, there's that boundary that shows us where that missing material is. Where's the rest of layer D? I see some D, the conglomerate D, but most of it's gone. Where's E? Where's the limestone E, especially maybe up in this corner up here? I can't find that anymore. It's missing. So before I deposit C and B, I'm going to have an unconformity. And then finally, notice that layers C and B are not folded, they are not intruded, they are not faulted. Since none of those events affected layers C and B, they must have happened last. They must be the youngest layers.
Yeah.